His building, so well packed, in the 1950s risked being demolished due to a project competition winner, which included a new arrangement in Piazza del Ferrares. It wasn't just an attempt at speculation. Because, at the time, the theme of its reconstruction in a modern key. He was the subject of a thesis in technical architecture, and no academician was scandalized. Today it has become untouchable. For what reason? Simply because it has become old, or because fashion is so called, is an asset, or does it become cultural? And then it is possible that even this ban on access becomes a cultural asset, become useless after the inversion of the one way. What influence does this state of confusion have on the education of our children? The cultural level of the children of this school can be comparable to that reached in this other one? Can learning how to read cultural assets help? In what language are they written? An agreement between the University of Bari and the Puglia region laid the foundations for a photogrammetric documentation center for cultural heritage. Photogrammetry is a technique that allows you to take measurements from the photographic image, and thanks to it, it was possible to obtain the cartographic representation of the territory in which we live. Today he can provide us with scale photographs. We can analyze, both in general and in particular, a historical center, choosing the point of view, which from time to time appears optimal to us. We can plan the visit down to the smallest detail. By sitting comfortably at a table, in order to use the time of the inspection for what actually interests us. But, in order for all this to be possible, it is necessary to know how to read the photographs. A multi-year experimentation for the teaching of photogrammetric language, it was started at a second and two fourth classes of the Balilla Elementary School in Bari. The program was inspired by the works presented by some children in a competition organized by LEGO and involves the construction of scale models, reproducing the most significant urban environments of Puglia, following the example of what Lego made in Berlund Park in Denmark. The competition was won by a model reproducing a miniature urban center. One of the many centers built without programming, at a small railway station. Only 4 scattered houses. Over time the population has grown, the isolated houses have been demolished for continuous high-rise buildings from the place. The small station has turned into a large railway junction, even served by the Trans-Europe Express. Now, many children want to participate in the game. But how is it possible? The small center does not have enough houses, the small community cannot live in chaos, it is necessary to elect a mayor. Protect citizens' rights. Organize a technical office to plan urban sprawl. Urban planning tools are missing. In short, all the problems of the cities in which we live are proposed again on a reduced scale. But, even the construction of a simple house requires preparation. Should we recover old buildings? The first designers were born, but how is it designed? The builders, who are part of another class, they will be able to understand the project represented only by prospectus and plans. Or perhaps it is better to send them a photogrammetric survey. Should the two techniques be integrated? Is graphically executing the project easy? Do you feel where other causes come you indicate with your finger? Can you touch them? What is this tool? Can you tell me what it's called?
Stereoscope.
What is it for?
To see 2 photos and see a third together.
What is this tool for?
To see the relief.
Should you prepare good designers, or is it better to use the computer? What design speed does it allow? Thank you. One moment, the computer can also do the calculations, so you can also follow the metric calculation in real time. The introduction of the computer risks not allowing all children to play. And if you had a lot of computers, the number of houses built would increase excessively. Or it could improve their quality, making them more comfortable. Let's hear what the protagonists think. Is it difficult to work with the computer?
Not much for me, because already the Commodore 64.
So it is difficult to work with the computer?
Not much.
But you need to know math well to be able to use it.
Yes. Did you like this year's experimentation?
Yes.
Is this study or play for you?
Game.
Just play?
Yes.
EPTE.
No, both things for me. That is, we can study and learn many things. Meanwhile, we can also have fun building many things.
Do you like working, playing on the computer?
Yes.
Do you think it is more instructive?
Yes.
And you like doing what you're doing? Do you think I study or play?
For me, both.
But would you like to have more information on these things? And use the computer more often?
Yes.
Do you think the experiment you have done this year has been interesting?
Yes.
Perché?
Because we learn more things and we can build new things.
What do you build?
What we imagine or what we think we are doing.
So what do you think of this initiative?
Here, for me, it was a very good didactic speech. And I can say it now, at the end of a year of this work, which was conducted weekly, with the collaboration of two teachers and Professor Dadabo, which offered us a more technical part, more technical help, as we needed specific terminologies and concepts, which we were not aware of, in a profound way. It is very possible to implement it. Because I saw the active participation of all the elements. Even the least gifted, so the positive results have been seen by all pupils. There has been no case of a child who has been absent, even partially, from each lesson. The speech started from cartography. With the presentation of the territory, to get to photogrammetry. That is to the observation of reality in the three dimensions.
And the children are therefore more interested in the study and practical implication of this experimentation?
Here, look, there is the study, which, then, if we want in this activity, we have touched to little different disciplines, such as geography for the territory, mathematics, geometry. They studied much more willingly than by studying these same things, as happened in the past years from the texts. They have found novelty or practicality. Or it is the reality that, seeing the reality that surrounds them in different ways, has interested them to such an extent that I have had solicitations from the pupils to continue this discussion.
So your invitation to go on?
Certainly, an invitation to go forward, both for me, as a school child, and for the colleagues, because precisely I want it to be clear to the other colleagues, that this work, which could frighten at first, must be undertaken with such enthusiasm, because the fruits are really positive.
Isn't there the same enthusiasm that all the teachers have for you?
In my circle there are few who have to feed it, but I will try to make it arise in the soul of my colleagues, through invitations to attend and follow our lessons, in order to try to involve them. I so that you can have open classes, for to be able to go on all together and not just the others.
Thank you. How was this new method set up in the second class?
So it all started as a game, and this of course fascinated the children, because we started from Lego and then, through Lego, first they built freely with Lego, then we went to design a house, therefore with very precise indications on the use of the Lego brick. So they built in part, because in order to build the whole house you need modules of two and in large quantities, which we don't have. However, they built only a part, a wall of the house, a facade of the house. After building it, it was drawn on sheets, in elevation and in plan. Then there was the verification on the computer, then each child, after planning and designed this wall of the house, he went to the computer and there he checked whether he had done well or not. Let's start from the concrete, which is the characteristic of children of this age. Starting from concrete things, and then we arrive precisely at this verification through a means that was completely unknown to children, but that they immediately learned to use and that especially fascinated them, because the moment they go there, from the facial expression, we understand the interest. That is, are they careful to see if they did well or not? So it was a very interesting thing. It is the fact that they are so very small, I think it has been positive.
So, all in all, can you equip your computer even up to the first classes?
I would say yes, because the important thing is to do this job in this new aspect, which is the binomial Lego computer.